So this is the intro to the final episode of the story of Keansburg, and it's really about Keansburg's future. I've spent a lot of time intimately throughout your streets, some of them dead ends and some of them not looking anything like the roads used to look back at the turn of the century. But I've gotten to know Keansburg pretty darn well. And hopefully people have gotten to know me. I've been stopped on the street by a number of people saying, hey, I know you, I recognize you. And some people on Facebook, and Keansburg Facebook especially, have been so kind in offering me suggestions about what to cover in the show and have corrected me when I've been wrong. Wait a minute, that's not the municipal sewage building, they say. Or that's not Lake Ellesmere. Lake Ellesmere is gone, and it was at the foot of some street. It went all the way to North Shore, etc. But this is about the future. And one man actually did stop me one day, and he says, hey, what are you doing? And I said, well, I'm doing the history of Keansburg. And he says, is this a good place to invest in? I just bought a home here, and I want to rent it and maybe sell it. I'm fixing it up. What do you think? And like Mayor George Hoff, I said to him, Keansburg is a great place to invest in. It's a work in progress. I like what they're doing. I'm at Cajere's restaurant, which is Highland Boulevard and Carr Avenue, which used to be a happening avenue back in the day. Now, not so much. Now, parts of Keansburg look a little scary, look like a ghost town. But let me assure you, and if you haven't seen it lately, or if you live in one part of town and you haven't ventured out into other parts of town, there's a lot happening here. You ought to be proud of the way people are taking care of their homes and refurbishing their homes and raising their homes and making their homes look really nice. You should also be proud of the fact that the businesses here in Keansburg are doing everything they can to try to promote other businesses. Now, you have to, if you live here, you have to support these businesses. You have to come out and pay your respects. People are coming here now. They are investing in Keansburg. There are high-rises going up, luxury townhomes going up on Beachway, 9 stories, beautiful. I might buy one there if I had the money. But this is the place for the future. And again, as George Hoff told me, it is a work in progress. So, welcome to the last installment of the story of Keansburg. It's the future, really. Take a look around, see how wonderful a place this is. I certainly enjoy it. When I first started my exploration in Keansburg, I started at the oldest and only burial ground that I know of, the True Axe Burial Ground. And the first thing I noticed was the natural beauty which is part of this town. In some ways, I felt closer to the past when I was surrounded by the natural world because I sensed what I believe the ancestors might have also seen. And water. Water was always critical to the town's success when it began as Tanner's Landing, then became Granville, and eventually what it is today, Keansburg. And the remnants of piers our ancestors built still refuse to disappear, at least for the present. Crabs and fish are easily grabbed by birds, just as people searched for the same as a source of food. Remains surrounded by a thick marsh as it winds its way to the small marinas where fishing and pleasure boats stand ready to head out for a day's outing, while birds patrol the muddy banks of the creek between small boat ramps and a bridge, bringing boaters, bathers, and boardwalkers from other parts of New Jersey. And here another ramp leans forward to the water. While Creek Road follows the slithering creek for as far as possible. Here it almost looks like a fishing village from another time, and just a few turns away from where the boats are docked. On this day, many of the tourists have left for the season, and some of the boats have been pulled out of the water, but not all have left the safety of this place in the creek. And through the floodgates installed by the U.S. Army Corps of Engineers, boats still have a little time to slip out to the bay before the winter blows a colder wind across the Raritan Bay. And near the tip of Keansburg, Coleman's Point. On the opposite side of the creek lies Beacon Beach and the somewhat secret pathway to find it. And Raritan Bay itself, which is filled mostly by the Raritan River as well as the Arthur Kill. And in the distance, the bay also leads to New York Harbor. And everyone in Keansburg can see New York City clearly. And almost everybody knows the horseshoe crab, which lives, loves, and dies along the bay's shoreline. And from the water, tourists, both today and yesterday, have always seen things a bit different than what they might see in other towns in the area. And then there's the pier, rebuilt and repositioned a number of times during the last 100 years. It was the way people would enter Keansburg after disembarking from steamships, which came from New York City. Today, the final stretch of planks were torn from the pilings during repeated attacks by hurricanes. And it doesn't matter too much because the steamship stopped bringing tourists here anyway in the early 1960s. Today, like so many pilings still reaching out to the bay, their only purpose is to jog an early memory, which is now fading into the past as those who remember are beginning to leave us. Bay Walk West on Belvedere Beach, and Bay Walk East, Point Comfort Beach, wind their way across the sand dunes and provide a flat surface for those who walk it. And then, in the midst of the natural world, is Keansburg Amusement Park, which faces the bay and the beach and pretty much speaks for itself. What else can you do in Keansburg? Well, hiking and cycling for one on the Henry Hudson Trail, which was the former site of a set of railroad tracks which brought trains with their passengers to the Keansburg train station, but today, no more. And there's nothing quite like biking the trail on an autumn day. There's Keansburg High School where I teach, and more about the high school a bit later in the program. And this trail generally runs from Matawan and a bit beyond all the way to Highlands, where it connects with another bike trail on Sandy Hook. And here comes White Cake Creek once again with a welcoming committee to say hello. And look, there they are in parade formation just for us. Or maybe not. Here's the creek from the air. You can see Raritan Bay in the distance. And those baseball fields over there, that's St. John's Field. And you can still see the creek on the other side of Route 36. And we're looking south, and now east. Looks like we got here just in time for the party. However, unfortunately, we have to keep moving if we're going to see everything. So let's check out some of the parks of Keansburg. First, let's pay our respects to those who served or lost their lives during the World War. And just down the avenue is the American Legion, Post 273. And here's Forest Park, where there are lots of recreational opportunities. And here's Friendship Park, located on Main Street and designed by local students. And then there's Lincoln Park with its miniature lighthouse. Why? Because the Beacon Lighthouse used to be located in this area, which is the eastern end of Keansburg. And here's a small park with a playground named after John Donahue III. And you saw this park from the air a few minutes ago. It's St. John's Field, which is next to Route 36 in the southwestern part of town. And the next park is in the northern part of the town. It's the Keansburg Firefighters Memorial Park. So now let's take a look at some of the homes and neighborhoods in Keansburg and listen to lifelong resident Mayor George Hoff.
Keansburg is my life. Keansburg is where I've lived for 45 out of my 47 years. Keansburg has been a work in progress. I've been on council since 2004. And we suffered not only with the economic crisis in 2008, but then we got hit by Hurricane Sandy, Superstorm Sandy in 2012. But Keansburg is now on the rebound. We have a lot of good projects on the, including a $63 million project on Beachway and Raritan Avenue, which is Cove by the Bay, being constructed by RPM, which is going to be a 9-story housing unit. We also have the TJK Stadium, which is going to be taken down and rebuilt into what's known as Pier 260, which is going to be a nice established restaurant with the view of the bay and the skyline. And we have the Arista project on the end of Beachway, Beachway West, by the Baywalk West, which is going to be 216 units of housing. Which is hopefully going to bring new and enthusiastic people into the town. We have a lot of projects on Carr Avenue that are starting. We've had, in the last 3 months alone, we've had 5 new businesses open up in town. So there's a lot of positive going on in Keansburg, and the vibe is getting out there. We still have a lot of empty buildings, unfortunately, and homes because of Sandy, but slowly but surely we're getting families to purchase them. Houses are being raised to come into compliance with the FEMA maps for flooding. So you have a lot of new houses being raised and refurbished because of that. So a lot of positive going on in Keansburg.
Oh, sure, some homes and buildings look better than others, but for the most part, homeowners and even renters seem to be taking care of where they live. These are nice homes in nice neighborhoods where from my viewpoint, the people in them seem very friendly. And one by one, the homes and the buildings, which were vacated after Hurricane Sandy, are either being raised, renovated, or torn down to build again. But it's going to take time to do any of these things. And most people in the Jersey Bayshore have experienced the same thing as the people in Keansburg. And then there are the businesses in town. One of the business owners is Cliff Moore, who owns Cajure's restaurant on Carr Avenue.
My name's Cliff Moore. I'm the Economic Community Development Coordinator for Keansburg. I also own a business in town called Cajure's, which is a restaurant on Carr Avenue. Well, the reason I took a chance here is because I saw so much potential and the changes that were taking place in Keansburg. And once I came and visited the town and educated myself, I realized that a lot of what people were talking about might have happened in the past, but it definitely wasn't what was going on now. And certainly because of the future that Keansburg's going to happen, I just believe it was to be at the right place at the right time. The history of Keansburg has been seasonal. I mean, in the 1900s, this was definitely a season. This was the tourist center from any place in the Northeast. People used to come here by ferry, by bus, but however they can get here, and they would rent bungalows for $15, $25 a week, and that's what it was back then. And now it's evolving more into a year-round community, where we have a new school that was just built, A lot of young families coming in, there's a lot of development, there's new houses going up, there's luxury apartments going up, there's new condos. And Keansburg right now is attracting a lot of young people, a lot of millennials that are coming in because it's very, very affordable.
I do know the town works very hard to, you know, when people come in to open businesses, whether they're somebody that's been in town 50 years or a guy just opened a new business, he's from, you know, Oshkosh. They do try very hard to work with the owners of the new business, get them through all the different permits and stuff, procedures, which probably is confusing.
When you're making an investment with a business to come over, you know, you want to make sure that the town is moving in the direction that you hope it wants to go to. People come into these Bayshore towns for one of two reasons. Either it's the activities and events, or it's food. It's the only reason you're going to come off Route 36. So we do have a great group of restaurants. We have more restaurants that want to come in. The local population, yeah, they visit the restaurants, but again, you know, we're talking 10,000 people live in 1.1 square mile. It's very, very difficult. So it's attracting the people from the outside. And once the people come here and they see Keansburg, I can tell you from my own restaurant and my own experience, people come in and say, wow, I didn't know Keansburg was like this.
And I can definitely see that 5 years from now, it's not a long time, 5 years from now, people will start talking about Keansburg like they do about Asbury Park, Red Bank, Long Branch, because that's what they went through, you know, as well. Negativity, now look at them. So it'll happen here in this town. And I'm so happy to be part of it.
Now the future is important, but history is treasured in Keansburg. So the Keansburg Historical Society has done its best to preserve all of the history at its museum on Carr Avenue. And the Keansburg Waterfront Library, with its spectacular view of Raritan Bay, not only provides resources to the residents of the town, it provides opportunities for local artists and photographers to show their works. Like these beautiful photos taken by local photographer Carly Venna. And of course the library has books, right? Right. But now let's go to another park where a memorial dedication is happening right now.
Today we're doing a groundbreaking for the EMS Council of New Jersey's 9/11 memorial for EMS workers. It's the only one in the country. It's the first one. And we are very, very proud that they selected Keansburg.
And the news media came to cover it.
It's a great honor because it recognizes all the EMS volunteers as well as the fire department and police that lost their lives that day. It's a memorial to the EMS workers that lost their lives that day. And it just for Keansburg to have this, it's a great honor. And we're humbled by the choice of the EMS Council to give us this piece of history here.
And lots of people from Keansburg also came out to attend this important event. Everybody in Keansburg appreciates the protection they receive from the local first responders, the firefighters, first aid folks, as well as the police. The people of Keansburg have a long time history in volunteering to serve the needs of their community, and their pride and dedication are always evident. And churches, too, are scattered throughout the town, like this one, St. Anne's, which recently celebrated its 100-year anniversary. And here's the First United Methodist Church on Church Street. And these are just two churches of many in Keansburg. And here is the Bayshore Senior Center on Main Street.
It's a very good service to them, not just health-wise, but emotionally as well.
This place is like a home. You feel welcome. And I love to see new people come because they don't know what to expect. And I think that they're really surprised when they realize how nice people are, how anxious they are to make everybody join and be together. And they're so nice to each other. That's what really impresses me.
And the staff at the Senior Center are really such great people and offer such terrific services to our senior citizens.
You know, it's a good town, a lot of good people. I mean, all summer long we had the crowds down the beachfront, we had crowds down on our beaches. I mean, the town ran several festivals, and July 4th festival, and we had no problems. They had the migration festival, we had, I think, 12,000 people down there. Everything worked smooth, there was no issues. And but that's always been the perception there that's been out there that, you know, oh, it's a tough town, it's this, it's that. And I think sometimes it's really an unfair, something to hang on to town.
And Keansburg's Recreation Department has done a marvelous job in providing opportunities for fun throughout the year. Here's the annual Irish Festival.
I remember we first used to come down in the to my grandmother's, and we'd be down for the summer, and then we'd go back to the city, you know, Labor Day. But we'd come down like in the winter, or whatever reason, and a little visit, and there was nobody here. And I'm sure Highlands was the same way. Day after Labor Day, Atlantic Highlands, they probably rolled up the streets. Everybody went home to the cities. Now you got nobody leaves after Labor Day.
This is the Mach 1. The guy wants $1,000 for it. Tell me about this car. I love this car. Look at this. You guys got to come down to Keansburg and see these cars. This is great. Wow. Very cool. Very cool.
And then no program about the future of Keansburg would be complete without looking at the schools, which are in fact so critical to the future of our town and to our country.
The Keansburg schools have 1,552 students. We have four buildings: Caruso Grammar School, we have the Port Monmouth, which will be a pre-K, Bulger Middle School, and the Keansburg High School. If you want to see something that's cutting edge, brand new, then you would look at the Caruso School as pretty much the model, and it's green, meaning it's got solar panels, LED lights, you know, all that kind of stuff. So it's pretty neat stuff. They have a surround sound theater, a rock climbing wall. It's three stories. It's, you know, elevated to in case we ever get flooded, which I hope we never have to happen. State-of-the-art cafeteria, a stage, the classrooms are, you know, everything is cutting-edge, state-of-the-art. The child study team is located in the back of the school, and there's new offices for them. It's over 100,000 square feet. It's pretty amazing. It's pretty amazing. Every classroom for the kindergarten is 900 square feet with a bathroom, which, you know, by code they have to, you know, by the new education standards they have to have. And yeah, that was opened last September, and we had our opening ceremony on the first day of school. So it was pretty awesome, pretty amazing. So we just had a meeting. I guess they had realtors come in, and everybody from the town sat, and they met with them, and they talked to them. And you know what, just telling them some of the initiatives, some of the things that are going on in our school district. You know, there's a group of, I don't even know how many people, 50 people or something. And they're all clapping, and you know, they believe. And yeah, so you want to be on the right side of this, because when this changes, everybody's going to say, I wish I was part of it then. So yeah, there's a lot of really, really good things. And you could just take a look at the high school. In the front of it, it doesn't have a dilapidated trailer in front of the high school anymore. And then when we have our new preschool, I mean, my gosh. But that's just another thing, just a lot of things. There are not kids who graduate from this high school that don't come back to the school in some way, shape, or form to work with the kids. It's home. And that's because of the relationships that the teachers establish with the kids.
I 150% believe that these kids on a desert island would survive and we would be led to a better future. I would want to be with these kids more than any other kids, because these kids know how to survive. These kids face real struggles every day, and they are so resilient. There's nothing that scares these kids. There's nothing that's going to bring them down. Just like we talked about before, when people say, oh, you know, Keansburg, that's tough. My kids know people say that about them. But every day, they're proving them wrong. And that's the satisfaction that we get. So I would rather be on a desert island with these kids than with anybody else, believe me.
I think Keansburg is like coming up in the world back to how it used to be in its glory days.
Yeah, we have a lot of good things in Keansburg, like the boardwalk. But I'd like to see that, like, better. Like, I want more people to come here. I want more people to say, ooh, Keansburg is a nice town. Like, I love the people that go to Keansburg.
I'd like to see the business aspect of the town start moving towards the right direction.
I'd like to see, like, the town, like you said before, the community and the know, backing up the school and our sporting events and, you know, also academics.
I think this town has the ability to be great, and because we're so small, there's everybody's so close together, and I think it's definitely possible.
We're not a secret anymore. People know that Keansburg is doing good. They see that the sports teams are getting better and that our education is just rising.
I think that everyone's opinions about Keansburg is going to change as a whole and not just think that we're some town that doesn't care about our students.
I feel like people look at us and automatically assume things, but I feel like we're changing that image, and I feel like the best way we can do it is just to continue what we're doing.
Keansburg is on the rebound. It's taken a while, but Keansburg is on the rise. We're getting the message out there about our beaches. We're getting the message about there about the opportunity for families to be able to come and live and start their families here. We're getting positive information out there to other towns, other communities, other parts of the state that Keansburg is a great place to live, and we welcome you and your families to be part of our great community. And we, the people that are here, we're advancing ourselves with not only recreational with a lot of activities that are going on with our new recreation department, but we're also building more, we're giving you more opportunity as far as new businesses in town, and we're trying to increase the value of your house by adding new structures to our community and new development to our community that's going to help increase that value. So there is a lot of positive going on in Keansburg, and that's the message I want to get out to not only our residents, but to the rest of the state and the rest of the country. Keansburg is on the rise.
So that's it. As one day ends, another begins in the history of the borough of Keansburg. And if you live here, well, you're part of it. And if you don't live here, well, just watch what happens. Stop by for a visit sometime. There's a lot happening right now, right here, today. So I hope you enjoyed all 8 episodes of The Story of Keansburg. And you know what I always say, if you see me out there among the marshes, climbing a tree or boating on the creek, well, if you can, please do tap me on the shoulder or yell at me and introduce yourself or say hello, because nothing is more important than meeting you. So long, folks. Oh, and thanks so much to everybody listed here who helped make this program possible. Bye-bye, everybody.